to spend my life mending broken people. I want to spend my life removing pain. Lord, let my words heal a heart that hurts. I want to spend my life mending broken people. I want to spend my life mending broken people.
Beautiful. That was beautiful.
It. That was fun.
Tim Parton, where do you come up with all of that stuff?
I'm as nervous about it as you are.
Well,
it just happens.
Honestly, when he plays, I mean, you couldn't think all those notes. It just comes from years of practice, right?
Oh, I guess, sir. From the Lord. I'll blame the Lord.
Well, absolutely. Oh, Yvonne, you better welcome. We got folks here. We're not by ourselves in the studio. We're doing a Today program, right?
That's right.
Somebody welcome John, C.A., somebody welcome our viewers.
We want to welcome you to a very special Today program.
That's good.
We're just having fun around the piano. I think this is one of the most, can we say, fun times we have when
Absolutely.
We don't really practice and we don't really prepare and we just pray and go.
That's right.
And that's why we were so amazed at Jim, because before he was playing some things, but he never played it like that. So every time it comes
never
out brand new.
Yeah.
Well, that's the difference really in a real musician and a person like myself who's an amateur. Like, I'll tend to play things the same way, but he has so much music in his head every time through, he can play something different. Now, there's times he's limited, because when you're doing studio sessions, nobody wants you to do all your own thing, right? Because you're walking around everybody else.
Right.
But now, this is the time to do it.
That's
Just turn loose and...
Let her rip, they
let
say.
Her rip. That's exactly right. Well, we are glad that you're joining us. We have Yvonne, got C.A., we got Pastor John, and... I started to say Pastor Tim.
Tiny Tim.
But Tiny Tim, he said. No, Brother Tim. Big Tim to me, I'll tell you, after playing like that. So we decided just to do a program that's fun and praising the Lord.
Amen.
And music is absolutely an incredible gift from God, isn't it?
It is.
And some folk, you know, it's not a matter of talent, who has talent, but to me, it's about praising the Lord.
Amen.
So even people who are not professionals, people
still
who don't have great,
noise, right?
They can make a joyful noise. And so that's what I do from time to time. And some of you don't laugh because that's all you do at home too. You're just making a joyful noise. There's not a lot of music coming out, but you know what? God is accepting that just as much as when Pastor John sings or anyone else or Sister Yvonne here sings. Mm-hmm. Because that's what it's all about, praising the Lord. But what a great, I can't tell you how many sometimes nights or evenings by myself I'd be traveling somewhere, driving a long trip. Mm. I bet you do that. As much as you're into music, you just break out in a little song.
Oh, mm-hmm. Yeah.
And it's just like a prayer. God inhabits the praises of his people.
That's
and
right.
when you love and serve the Lord, it's going to come out.
That's
and
right.
I'm glad that he gave music. But some of us just was able to go a little bit farther in the music, like Tim, than the rest
he
of us.
He stayed on the bus.
Yeah, I stayed on the bus.
He did. What are we going to do next? Let's see. We've written down some songs, and we'll take them in order or not. But we've got The Blood Will Never Lose Its Power. Tell us about the song.
This song takes me back to Oakwood. I know that C.A. Was there. Yvonne was Dr. Yvonne Lewis. Yvonne to me. And The Blood of Jesus, if you think of the one component that takes us from bound to freedom.
Mm.
It's the blood of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
And so people think, well, okay, that was 2,000 years ago. Will there ever need to be a substitute?
Mm.
Well, the writer of this song says the blood will never lose its power.
Yeah.
So for those of you that are Oakwood alumni, or if you have heard this song before, no matter what denomination, it takes us to that gospel place.
Amen.
Where we remember the greatest investment Jesus ever made was his blood. Mm. Listen to it.
Andre Crouch song, right?
That's right. That's right.
The blood that Jesus shed for me. Power.
Boy, you really came out with that strong. It's a powerful song.
It is a powerful song.
And John, you chose that today. As you said, it had meaning to you.
Right. The blood. Where would we be? How many times did we need another drop of blood to clean us up? Mm-hmm. And if the blood of Christ had ever been exhausted, then there would be a cutoff point where nobody else could be saved. But the blood of Jesus never loses its power. Yeah. Praise God for that.
That's the burden of the book of Hebrews. Yeah. That's the burden of the book of Hebrews, mm-hmm. that Christ is all sufficient and the blood never loses its power.
And that was penned by Andre Crouch, isn't that right?
That's right. Absolutely. Powerful song. Takes us way back to Oakwood.
Yeah, great
songwriter. Didn't take me back to Oakwood. Did it, you, Tim?
Nope.
I don't know about this deal.
Sorry, you can be honorary Oakwood.
Oh, we can? Yeah. Okay, good.
Yeah, you do have that plaque from Oakwood. So
I do have a plaque. That's true. You know what? I do love going there. And the music, talk about music, that church. Oh. Tim, if you've never been to Oakwood University, you ought to go and listen to some of the choirs and the musicians. And Steve Darmody said to me once when he was listening to that, he said, "That makes me want to give up." He said, "It makes me want to quit. I've sang all my life, but I hear some of these folks sing." So that's the way I feel. So you may not want to, some of us, we go, just enjoy it. Just be glad that the folks are doing what they're doing. And such an anointing and such great music. And so speaking of that, wasn't a meant to be a plug for Oakwood, but being there, I'm always blessed by the music that they have. I'm also blessed by this guy, though, Tim Parton and his music. Mm-hmm. And Tim, you're going to do something for us today. Yeah. And I ask you to sing anything you wanted to play. Tell us why you chose this song.
This is a song that I remember singing as a kid before I really probably understood what it meant to totally surrender your life to Christ.
Okay.
But I grew up in a singing family. We sang all throughout the week and at churches on the weekends. And everywhere we went, this was what I sang. And now I sing it with greater conviction because it's wonderful. Even more so the truth.
Great.
It's my desire to live for Jesus. It's my desire to be like Him. Though often I fail and brought Him much shame, it's my desire to live for Him. It's my my desire to help someone today, someone who might have failed to see the way. For I too was once so lost, but I found my way to God. It's my desire to live for Him. If you could see where Jesus brought me from to where I am today, then you would know the reason why I love Him so. Now you can take this whole world, it's well, I don't need earth's fame. It's my desire. It's my desire to live for Him.
Beautiful.
Amen.
An absolutely beautiful song, and great job, Brother Tim Parton. That song goes back, but I'm surprised. When it came out, I'm grown and everything else and don't think anything about it. Tim just said it hit me. When I was a kid, I learned this, and I'm like, wait a minute. You were a kid when that song came out, because like I had a family and was, you know, but he was a kid when that song came out. I've been singing that since I was a kid, and I'm like, what? I forget how young you are, Tim.
And well, I apparently do too.
Now,
and I'm sorry.
It has nothing to do with your looks. I'm not saying you look old or anything like that. Now, how do I get out of this, Yvonne? Is it too late to get out of
that song?
Go to the next song. Tell you what I'll do. I feel so bad about saying this, and maybe it been taken wrong in any way, whatever. I don't know how it would be, but I think just for that, we should let him play another song.
Oh, okay.
Great idea.
It may be called Punishment by some people, but it's not for Tim, because what an incredible talent. Just anything that you want to play, and we're going to be happy about it.
Okay.
All right?
Thank you.
Amen. Amen. You know what I think we should do, because most of our folks at home would know that. Why don't you go back to the original key you started out with, and let's just sing unison with that, and have the folks at home to sing I Come to the Garden Alone, maybe just the first verse or so, right?
Nice.
I come to the garden. Thank you so much. Isn't that beautiful? What a beautiful song.
I was just ministered to by just every style and every place you went.
Yes.
I was in the garden, then I was in Carnegie Hall.
Yeah.
And then I was in Radio City Music Hall. But everywhere I went, it was this constant journey of how beautiful the gift of music is that God entrusted to us. I mean, if music is this beautiful and this
on earth.
Oh. Can you imagine?
I cannot imagine what it's going to be like in the kingdom.
Yeah.
And to know that God has anointed you with that. And you know, that's I can't say it's a gift. I have to say it's an anointing.
It's an anointing. Mm-hmm.
Because like you said, Danny, when it's a gift, sometimes you write all the notes down. How do you write that down?
No, you don't. Yeah.
You don't write that down.
You don't
but
write
to God
the anointing.
Be the glory.
The anointing is the
well,
chosen.
Speaking of writing things down, I'd like to hear a song that you've recently written.
Oh, that's right.
I was going to bypass that after all of that, but I had written a chorus a couple years ago, and just talking to the Lord one night by myself, and just, you've been good to me, and Lanny Wolf heard it, and so he actually said to me, and of course, folks, I'm sure most of our folks are familiar, if you're familiar with gospel music at all, Lanny Wolf written so many tremendous songs, he actually called me and said, well, if you want, I'll put some verses to that, you just have some choruses. And I'm like, absolutely, absolutely. But it's literally brand new, so I've never done it. This would be the first time I'm actually written the words down, because I did the music and the words to the chorus, and then he put the music and the words to the verses, and somehow he makes it all work out. So I'm going to give it a whirl. If I don't do so well, we'll start over and I'll try it again. All right?
Will take eternity.
eternity. For you've been good to me through all the years. You've been good to me through joys and tears. I want to thank you, Lord, for all you've done. You've been good to me through all the years. When I was weak, your strong arms carried me. When afraid I felt, your hand in mine. Through all life's ups and downs, you were there for me. And with a grateful heart, I want to thank you, Lord, just one more time. You know, sing it with me. You've been good to me through all the years. You've been good to me. You've been good to me through joys and tears. Through joys and tears. I want to thank you, Lord. I want to thank you, Lord, for all you've done. You've been good to me through all the years. Has the Lord been good to you today?
Oh, yes.
Has he been good to you at home today? I mean, what a privilege that we can serve a risen Savior. What a privilege that God would reach down and use any of us. I'm amazed. Through the last 32 years, I've had my ups and downs.
You know, Dan, I'm thinking as you were singing, there was a time not too long ago we were wondering whether you were going to speak again, let alone sing.
Yeah.
And we prayed and we prayed, and God has brought you back, man, and we praise the Lord for that.
Well, he has, and for the folks at home, you know what I'm talking about. But just think about it, how good God is to us. I can look back and personal things, and when you're a public figure, a lot of times these are public, it becomes public, I wanted to say information, but a lot of times gossip. You know, some things are true, some things aren't. But when I look back over all the years, I wouldn't trade one thing. I would not trade one thing. And I'll take that to my grave. Now, I'm not saying I wouldn't try to do better and improve on this. But if I knew when the Lord told me in 1984, I want you to build a television station that would reach the world with an undiluted three angels' messages, one that would act a counterfeit, and I could look down the stream of time 32 years later, knowing the ups and downs, I would still say, you've been good to me.
Nice. All right.
Through all the years. Not gonna get through this one. You've been good to me through joys and tears. I wanna thank you, Lord. Oh, for all you've done for me. Why? Because you've been good to me through all the years. Yes, you've been good to me through all my life, actually, in the past 32 years. Tell me a little bit, Yvonne. God's been good to you. Share me a little testimony for the folks at home.
As I listen to you, you know, I think the same thing, Danny. I think that there's nothing that I would change because God's had his hand in my life the whole time, my whole life. And so though I've been through loss and pain and just like everybody has a story, but we know that God's love will never let us go. Okay. We know that he will hold us and he will keep us. And if you are going through a really dark time right now, just know that this too shall pass and that life does not stay the same. So don't lose hope, because God's got you and He's not going to let you fall. If you don't know Jesus Christ for yourself, ask Jesus to come into your life. Tell Him you're thankful for what He's done for you, that he shed His blood for you, and ask Him to forgive you of your sins and to change your life. And He will do that. He will do that. We are living testimonies of the gift of God. So just hold on. Know that He's not going to let you go. And know that He's always going to be good, good to you. Because that's who He is.
Amen. And it won't take an eternity for us to understand that. Literally, at the second coming, everything that you've gone through on this earth.
That's right.
My dad used to say, won't mount to a hill of beans, right? That's kind of a country term. You probably heard that, Tim. But as soon as the eastern sky breaks and you're able to see Jesus, you'll say, you've been good to me through all the years. You've been good to me through joys and tears. I want to thank you, Lord, for all you've done. You've been good to me through all the years. You'll say that, I promise you. And right now, no matter what's going on in your life, just know that Jesus loves you. He died for you. He made a plan of salvation for you. He's coming back very soon in the clouds of glory. And we all can say, God's been good to us. Yes. C.A., John, you give a little testimony. Then C.A., I want you to give yours through song. Mm-hmm. All right?
I've taken up a hobby a little bit more than a year ago. I try to do something new every year. Okay. And this year, I actually... 2017 now. In 2016-15, I decided to, I like astronomy, not astrology, astronomy, which is the study of the heavens, the study of the stars and planets. And first I began by just looking at the internet, looking at different pictures, the Horsehead Nebula, the Orion Nebula, all these different things. Then I found out there was a program on the iPad called Redshift, and I downloaded that, and I became fascinated to find out how short our lives are and how much time God wants to give to us. And so I put in a scenario, and which, how much more of the heavens would I see if I lived to be 100? And it astounded me. They said they'll do it in time lapse. In other words, okay, if you're going to see this much more, it'll really swing. It only moved like a quarter of an inch. And I thought, you mean if I live to be 100 years old, I'll only get a chance to see a quarter of an inch more sky? That's not even fair. And then I began going to different planets and different constellations, light years, you know, 500 million, 500 light years away. And I'm thinking, honey, Angie said to me, John, don't even tell me anymore. We're not going to live that long. and we've been saying lately to each other.
Live that long.
So I said to her, honey, right now, I've got eternity in view.
There you go. Mm.
We have been messing around with earth, but God wants to take us to His playground.
Come on.
So when the heavens depart as a scroll, and as you said, all this down here won't amount to a hill of beans. So here's our new saying. We hold on to the world ever so lightly, and we hold onto God's hand with a stern grip.
Love it.
Because He's been good. He's got more years, as you would say in the song. He's been good to us all these years, and He's got eternity to give to us.
Yeah, that's good.
All right. Beautiful. Dr. Murray?
Praise the Lord. God is good. And He is insistent, incessant, persistent, consistent, and He never lets us go.
Come on.
Amen. Let me go. I rest my weary soul in thee. I give thee back
the life I own, that in thine ocean depths its flow may richer fuller be. O cross that lifteth up my head, I dare not ask to fly from thee. I lay in dust, life's glory dead, and from the ground there blossoms red, life that shall end, endless be.
Beautiful, beautiful. Why'd you pick that song today? That's a beautiful song, but
Just thinking about, you know, when you were talking right now, your brother is going through some medical stuff.
Yes.
And I went through that same medical stuff. Mm-hmm. And the fact that, you know, we were in Sabbath school the other day, and they said, look back at your life and see if you really have had a hard life. And I think about where I grew up in my family. And I've gone through cancer and gone through 6 bypasses and had a dozen eye operations and been blind for a period of time.
And you're still here.
But I'm still here. But as I look back, I cannot say my life has been that hard.
No.
Because God has been that good.
Yeah. You know,
I've gone through stuff, but I got stuff. You got stuff.
Yeah.
All God's children
got stuff.
But we also got Jesus.
Amen.
And as long as you've got Jesus, you got all you need. So I look back, hadn't been that bad.
No.
And the future is real bright, Pastor.
That's right. They said the retirement plan is out of this world.
Amen.
So you're, when this is over, you're going to learn the song, You've Been Good to Me.
Yeah.
Right? There you go.
I'll probably never sing it as good as you, but it's a beautiful song.
You will. Pastor John?
We talk about trials in this life. You know, there's a text in the Bible, and there's so many texts about trials, but it says, through much tribulation, we will enter the kingdom of heaven.
Mm-hmm.
And I wish it were just through tribulation. But it's through much. And if you've been around any length of time, you know that you've been through a lot of tribulation. And you say, Lord, thank you for not showing me 2 years from now. Because if we anticipate the future, sometimes it's too great for us to even, in anticipation, to say, what do we do to prepare for the next trial?
Mm.
And I remember one pastor C.A. once said, he said, if you haven't been through it, just wait. It's coming.
That's right.
But in every one of those, I've discovered something. Even the silence of God does not equal the absence of God.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
And I also said, when you go through difficulty, who do you tell? And I've discovered him, Danny, Yvonne, C.A. There's nobody better to tell than to tell Jesus.
Amen.
Someone walk us back through a song. I must tell Jesus all of my trials.
Good.
I cannot bear my burdens alone.
Mm-hmm.
If you know the song, you can hum along with me, or you can sing in your home or with your family. But we're going to sing the song together. I'll do the choruses, and you guys come with me on the verses. I mean, I'll do the verse, you do the chorus, and we'll praise the Lord together. I must tell Jesus.
I must tell Jesus all of my trials. I cannot bear these burdens alone. In my distress, He kindly will help me. He ever loves and cares for His own. If I but ask him,
praise the Lord. What a beautiful song. Even if we didn't get to practice it very much, amen. I hope the folks at home are singing so loud they don't hear little issues with us here. So hopefully you've been singing along with us. But this is just today is just a wonderful day to praise the Lord. And, you know, we have guests sometimes and we talk about things and behind the scenes and do all sorts of things and world travels of what's happening around the world with 3ABM. But today we said, why don't we just enjoy this with the folks at home? And I think it's really been good. I know I've been blessed because we felt the anointing of the Holy Spirit. No one here can bless each other and no one can bless you, but the Holy Spirit's what blesses you. So when you get in the mood, as they say, to say, okay, Lord, I'm here to praise you, watch what God does. Yeah. Watch the doors that he opens. I had a friend of mine years ago I grew up with. He was a Pentecostal. Roy Groves is his name. Some of our viewers will know him, bass singer, beautiful voice. And no matter where he went to church, I went to him at his Pentecostal church, and he just sat up front and praised the Lord. And one day I invited him to come to our Adventist church, a little more conservative. He sat up front, and people's much more quieter. It's white church, CA, much more quieter. And he was still, praise the Lord, praise you, thank you, Jesus. And so I thought, well, he's not going to really, he's used to this, all of this, you know. And after church was over, he said, man, I've never felt the Holy Spirit any better than I felt it in that church. I'm telling you, this church, the Holy Spirit was there, and it occurred to me, because it was with him. Yes. He came there to praise the Lord. So he wasn't worried what somebody else did or didn't do. Did this person, are they saying amen? Can I say something? He just does the same as no matter where he is, amen. Praise the Lord. So that's what happened today. We're just here praising the Lord.
Amen.
Yvonne, you got a song that I think we have time. Yeah, we do. We have time for you to do it. But tell us a little bit about the song, and you chose it today.
Yeah, you know, this past week, I was out in California with Yolanda Palmer, and we were working on some scripture songs, and they're doing this wonderful project, and it was really a blessing. And she and I started talking about where we were in the world and the things we used to do and the money that we were making, but the emptiness that went along with it. And we wouldn't trade where we are now, amen, walking with the Lord, for God, anything. So as we think about the lyrics to the song, like all the money, all the whatever it is we had, all the accoutrements of wealth and all that, it doesn't amount to anything. Mm-hmm. And all that we have now, we just want to surrender it all to Jesus.
Amen.
So this song has particular meaning for us, and I hope it does to you as well. Surrender all. I
Amen. Beautiful. Thank you, Yvonne. I'm thinking about our folks at home, our viewers at home, and maybe you've not really surrendered to the Lord Jesus Christ. I've been amazed over the years and at the people that have, I remember a pastor came here once. He said, I really want to talk to you. He was from a neighboring state. He said, I've been a pastor for 34 years. I retired this past year, but I never knew Jesus until I started watching 3ABN this past year. He was too busy. He said, I was just too busy in my own life and my own world to really watch. You know, I've heard of 3ABN, but never really watched it. But after all of these years, I surrendered my life to Jesus. Now, that almost, to some of us, would seem impossible. You'd say, he made that up. I couldn't have made that up. I wouldn't even have thought it. But I think about the Sabbath school teachers, Sunday school teachers, the pastors, no matter what church you are, deacons, elders, today would be a good time to look at our life and maybe just stop for a minute and say, Lord, where am I? Yeah. Where am I in relationship to you? Have I surrendered my everything, my all to you? Have I submitted and committed my life to Jesus? Because we're so busy working for the Lord. And those in ministry, folks watching in ministry, no matter what that ministry is, are you too busy working for the Lord to really have a relationship with the Lord? Are you too busy in what you're doing to hear the voice of the Lord? But it all starts in surrender. Without surrendering to Jesus, it's all in vain, the work that we do. Why don't we just sing the chorus again, Yvonne? I surrender all. Just do the chorus.
I surrender. Thank you.
Amen. We're going to take a short break, and we'll be right back. Well, as they say, time flies when you're having fun. And we've had a great, fun time together. Been a spiritual time, but I think a fun time also.
For sure.
And an anointed time. So thank you, Tim, for being here, Pastor John, Pastor C.A., and Yvonne. For those of you at home, thank you for your love and your prayers and financial support of 3ABN as we endeavor to take an undiluted Three Angels messages, one that would counteract the counterfeit into all the world. Now, you're all family. We're family here. You're family. You just today, you happen to be on the other side of the camera. But we're going to go out and do something different today. We're going to go out singing that I'm so glad I'm a part of the family of God. You sing with us now. I'm so glad I'm a part of the family of God. I've been washed in the fountain. Travel this side, for I'm part of the family of God. I'm so glad I'm a part of the family of God. I've been washed in the fountain, cleansed by His blood, joined heirs with Jesus as we travel. Washed in the fountain.